In Ukraine's battle for air supremacy with Russia, a swarm of tiny Black Hornet drones might just give it the edge. These drones act as eyes for Ukrainian troops on the ground, and thanks to the US, UK, and Norway, Ukraine now has an entire fleet of them ready to be deployed at a moment's notice. In July 2023, the United States announced that it would deliver $400 million in security assistance to Ukraine. Beyond the typical armored vehicles and air defense missiles, that package would also include Black Hornet drones made by Teledyne FLIR Defense. A month later, the UK made a similar announcement. Working with Norwegian manufacturers, it would spend $9 million on these micro-drones, sending them over to Ukraine for use as covert surveillance tools. All told, Ukraine now has over 1,000 of these drones at its disposal, and they're helping Kyiv slowly turn the tide against Putin's invading forces. But how? How could a tiny drone, designed to look like a helicopter, have such a huge impact? To answer that question, we must start by asking the following. What are Black Hornet drones? The simple answer is they are miniature unmanned aerial vehicles, or UAVs, that are designed specifically for reconnaissance. Unlike many of the other drones that Ukraine uses, some of which come equipped with attack capabilities, the Black Hornet drone is all about stealth. But that's just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to its superpowers. The first generation of these drones was created in 2011 by Teledyne FLIR and quickly found themselves in heavy use in Afghanistan. They're designed to be small enough for ground-based troops to carry. They even come with their own carry case, and they can be deployed at a moment's notice. In Ukraine's case, they've received shipments of the Black Hornet 3, which measures just 6.6 inches from nose to tail and weighs only 1.16 ounces. In other words, they're tiny. So tiny, in fact, that the drones are easy to hide among foliage and trees, making them almost imperceptible to opposing troops unless the drones are flown straight into them. Furthermore, the drones are designed to be practically silent when in operation. The telltale buzzing that usually accompanies these types of UAVs isn't present, making it even harder to detect the Black Hornet. Also, unlike other drones, the Black Hornet does away with the quadcopter design that's typically used for UAVs. Instead, it looks like just a tiny helicopter, only one that's equipped with several high-definition cameras that are capable of sending footage to the operative controlling the drone. That design choice also means that Black Hornets can squeeze through much smaller gaps than quadcopter UAVs, ideal for sneaking into buildings and navigating difficult terrain. The Black Hornets have an impressive 25-minute flight time, giving the user plenty of time to get in and out with the drone, and takes about the same amount of time to recharge. As a result, the drone can be deployed several times per day, with each flight revealing more about the area over which it flies. But all of that tech doesn't come cheap. The most recent publicly available pricing for the drone puts it at $195,000 per unit. Given that Ukraine has received about 1,300 of the drones since the beginning of Putin's war, that would mean that Kyiv's Black Hornet fleet has cost $2.73 billion to date. That's a lot of money to spend on a fleet of tiny helicopters, but it's money well spent once you recognize the extent of the Black Hornet's abilities. First, there's the simple ease of deployment to consider. Unlike traditional drones, which often need to be launched from the ground and will weigh down any troops carrying them, the Black Hornet is so tiny that it can be launched from a soldier's hand. Seeing one take off is almost like watching somebody launch a toy helicopter. Just place it on a surface and hit a button. The drone zooms into the air to be directed by the soldier's remote control from the ground. That simplicity makes it a weapon of immense power. Granted, the Black Hornet has no attack capabilities, meaning it isn't a weapon in the traditional sense, but the fact that it can be launched by anyone from almost anywhere gives it a level of versatility that most drones simply don't offer. A platoon of soldiers could send several of them into the skies in an instant, giving them a clear bird's-eye view of the terrain below. And when the Black Hornet is done, it can be landed right back on the soldier's hand and tucked into a pocket. However, the miniature nature of the drones does come with some downsides. When the British first started using the Black Hornet in Afghanistan in 2013, they found that something very simple could cause issues – a gust of wind. According to one soldier, a good gust of wind will send the Black Hornet off, meaning that Ukraine's soldiers face some limitations when using them. Still, those limitations aren't quite as severe as what the Brits faced. Back then, the Black Hornet weighed just 16 grams, making it easy to knock off course. The third generation of the device, the one being sent to Ukraine, is a little heavier and is now capable of standing winds of up to 17.3 miles per hour. That's more strength than the Black Hornet used to have. However, according to the Beaufort wind scale, a 17.3 mile per hour wind qualifies as a moderate breeze, If the wind is strong enough to raise dust from the ground or rustle loose paper, it's probably strong enough to knock a Black Hornet off course. Rain can also be an issue. According to Teledyne FLIR's specifications document, the Black Hornet can handle precipitation of 0.1 inches, which qualifies as a light rain. Anything above that means the rain is so heavy that the tiny drone can't fly properly, meaning it's best deployed when conditions are clear. Still, it has a solid temperature range of between 14 and 109.4 degrees Fahrenheit, making it usable in freezing cold conditions and extremely hot locations. Having a weapon that can be overcome with a decent gust of wind or a little bit of rain might not seem like the best idea in the world. But the Black Hornet makes up for that design issue, which is inherent in something as small as the drone, with amazing stealth capabilities. The drone comes equipped with a set of tiny electronic motors that are battery-powered and combined with the aerodynamic design to make it extremely quiet when it's in the air. The drone is practically silent, with almost none of the telltale buzzing seen in other UAVs. That's ideal for its use to surveil hostile environments. Even a slight amount of background noise serves as enough cover to make the Black Hornet drone almost impossible to hear. According to engineering.com, a soldier will have no idea it's even there as long as the drone stays more than 10 feet away from them. That near silence is complemented by a smart design to emphasize control. Assuming the drone flies in relatively windless conditions, its slight wing shape, coupled with a design inspired by birds and insects, means it can be controlled almost perfectly. The drone can turn on a dime, with little to no build-up needed to get it to navigate corners. Again, that makes it useful in stealth operations, as a soldier can quickly fly the Black Hornet around a corner or behind a tree to prevent anybody from being aware of its presence. The vortex generators installed on the Black Hornet's wings play a large part in improving the drone's handling. These generators create small vortices of air, localized to small portions of the wings, that allow for easier control when the drone is moving at slow speeds. The generators also reduce stall speeds, allowing the user to quickly slow down and, when conducting surveillance, to have the drone hover in place so it can get clear shots of its surroundings. Better yet, the drone can fly up to heights of 1.5 kilometers, approximately 0.93 miles, again allowing for quick escapes. Then there are the Black Hornet's image-capturing capabilities to consider. The drone often comes in sets of two, with one being equipped with cameras to capture daytime footage, while the other specializes in shooting footage at night. The unit comes with a pair of electro-optical, or EO, cameras, one at the front and one that shoots footage below the drone, that can capture video at a 640 by 480 resolution. If a soldier wants to take photos of the environment, those EO cameras can send back pictures with a resolution of 1600 by 1200, strong enough to record even the smallest of details on the battlefield. The thermal imaging cameras built into the nighttime versions of the drone aren't as powerful. They deliver video and images at a resolution of 160 by 120. That's enough to get a general idea of how many troops may be in a location, for instance, though not detailed enough to deliver any specifics. All imagery and video can be recorded or streamed live to a tablet operated by the user, with the Black Hornet having a radio range of 1.24 miles. That's more than enough for covert operatives to maintain their distance from a target while surveilling it. Best of all, every scrap of the drone's recorded footage is encrypted and stored on a 64GB SD card that can be easily removed or replaced as needed. The same goes for the cameras. All can be replaced with spares if they happen to go offline for any reason. The manufacturers have gone to great lengths to ensure that the cameras are easy to use. With the tablet that comes with the Hornet, a soldier can simply tap a screen to take a snapshot, all while watching streamed video. It's almost like playing a video game. Using the tablet and a remote control, the user moves the drone around, hitting a button to take snapshots whenever they're needed. But what if a soldier doesn't want to put themselves at risk while controlling the drone? Thanks to the Black Hornet's advanced artificial intelligence, or AI, systems, they don't have to. Each Black Hornet comes equipped with an autonomous navigation mode that allows the user to pre-program a flight route into it. That programming means it can fly to its target without being directly controlled, with the drone even having the ability to return to its dock automatically when it senses that it's running out of juice. The AI built into the drone is also able to adapt to changing environmental conditions. That's ideal if wind or rain pushes it off course. Using its AI, the Black Hornet can course correct, so it gets back onto its intended flight path. This autonomy is achieved through a small array of onboard sensors built into the drone, which help it to detect obstacles nearby so that it doesn't accidentally collide with them. Advanced GPS built into the drone also makes it easy to set a route. Simply choose a location, and the drone can use its GPS systems to figure out the best way to get there. All of that data that the Black Hornet picks up via its sensors is fed through complex AI algorithms, enabling it to fly safely without anybody being in direct control. There's even an optional visual-based navigation unit that the drone can use to fly indoors when it has no access to GPS. So it's an impressive piece of technology. But how has Ukraine been using the Black Hornet? The clear and most obvious use is for reconnaissance and surveillance. As Ukrainian troops advance on Russian positions, they can deploy the drones ahead of themselves to get the lay of the land before they launch operations. And thanks to the drone's high-resolution cameras, they can track Russian troop movements easily, figuring out the best times and places to strike. Think about this potential scenario. A Ukrainian platoon advances to the edge of a Russian position. Hiding out of sight, a soldier launches a Black Hornet and sends it flying high above the Russians, where the drone spends about 20 minutes recording footage and sending snapshots. Immediately, the Ukrainians can see how many soldiers are stationed at the Russian position, as well as get detailed imagery of artillery and other weapons. They'll also see weak points. Any gaps in the Russian defense can be picked up by the Black Hornet, with the drone being small enough to fly in and out of buildings, as well as around rubble, to locate an ideal attack position. And as one drone runs out of power and has to return to the soldier who launched it, another drone can be sent into the skies to replace it. That's where the drone's small size becomes a massive advantage. According to The Economist, a single Ukrainian platoon has 20 soldiers. Each of these soldiers could easily carry a Black Hornet, delivering about 400 minutes of surveillance footage per platoon. A small fleet of Hornets could easily surveil an entire Russian station in minutes, with the footage being stitched together to reveal everything about what the platoon will face when it launches its attack. The Russians would have no idea that the Hornets are even above them. It's this ability to surveil that also helps Ukraine to knock Russian jets out of the sky. The Black Hornet is so tiny that it simply doesn't show up on a jet's radar. And even if a pilot spots it, the jet won't be able to do a thing to destroy the drone. The Black Hornet is far more maneuverable. Before the pilot could even adjust their jet to fire on it, the drone would be gone, likely heading back to its user. And just like that, the Ukrainians would know exactly where the jet is and the flight path it's taking. The Russian pilot would have two choices: either abort their mission and turn back, risking the wrath of Moscow by failing to complete their objective, or carry on flying, likely into Ukrainian anti-air defenses, and risk losing their plane and their own life. It's a lose-lose situation. Assuming the pilot even sees the Black Hornet tracking them, the likelihood is that they won't, meaning the Ukrainians can launch their anti-air attacks before the pilot even realizes what's happening. These scenarios aren't outside the realms of possibility. According to the European Council on Foreign Relations, or ECFR, Ukraine used the larger TB2 drone to help it target the initial Russian convoy that tried to ride into Kyiv. It's also believed that a TB2 was used to distract the defenses of the Moskva ship, giving Ukrainian soldiers enough time to fire the naval missiles that ultimately sank the Russian vessel. With the Black Hornet, Ukraine has an even smaller drone at its disposal, one that will help targeting without ever being spotted by the enemy. Consider also the propaganda uses of the Black Hornet. Recording footage of Russian troop movements may be useful for Ukrainian attacks, but it also shines a light on what those troops are doing as they advance. Every atrocity committed, every civilian killed. If a Black Hornet is present, it can all be filmed and distributed, helping Ukraine to make an even better case for why the rest of the world needs to help them overcome the Russian threat. And thanks to the Black Hornet's high-resolution snapshots and high-quality video feeds, there will be no doubting any of the footage the drone shot. Again, this is a proven Ukrainian tactic. Kyiv has used drones to document the destruction of several Ukrainian cities during the war, as well as the breaching of the Kakhovka Dam. It also uses drones to record its own attacks against Russian ships, tanks, and jets, all valuable morale-boosting propaganda to spread among its forces. There's also the simple fact that using drones protects troops. In the case of the Black Hornet, that's been a proven benefit of these UAVs since they were first deployed in Afghanistan. Newsweek made that clear when it shared the comments of Major Adam Foden, a British soldier who used them during his time fighting against Afghan insurgents. "Previously, we would have sent soldiers forward to see if there were any enemy fighters hiding inside a set of buildings," he said. "Now we are deploying Black Hornets to look inside compounds and to clear a route through enemy-held spaces." Ukraine is doing the same. Every Black Hornet deployed accounts for one soldier who doesn't have to risk their life to surveil a Russian position. Ukraine gets to protect its troops, who can stay over a mile away from a Russian position, while still receiving a clear video feed that shows them exactly what they need to know. This risk reduction means that a Ukrainian platoon doesn't have to take any chances and lose valuable members just to figure out how to launch an attack. It can use Black Hornets and attack at full strength every single time. However, using the Black Hornet doesn't come without risk. That was made clear in a July 2023 article published in Bulgarian Military, which said that soldiers from Russia's Wolves Brigade, a reconnaissance unit, had captured two of the drones. Both were seized during a shootout in Novaya Tavolzhanka that resulted in the Russians managing to retain the trophy control complex. That was a significant event. The Black Hornet is made using proprietary technology to which the Russians don't currently have access. Teledyne FLIR isn't selling to them, which means they can't fill the skies with swarms like the Ukrainians can. Yet. Now that they have a pair of these drones, Russia can try to reverse engineer them to figure out the science and tech behind how they work. Whether they'll be successful or not is another matter. The Black Hornet uses encryption to protect the videos that it shoots, so you have to assume that it has even more powerful encryption guarding the AI algorithms and subroutines built into its system. But even if it takes Russia years to come up with its own version of the Black Hornet, the fact that it has the tech in its hands makes the process a little more straightforward. And even if Moscow decides not to go down the reverse engineering route, it can at least use this pair of Hornets. It can figure out their capabilities and, possibly, figure out a way to counter them. Or with more captures, it may be able to build up a small fleet that it can use to plan attacks of its own in the future. The Ukrainians could start to see their own tech being used against them if they're not careful. Still, the use of Black Hornet drones has been a massive boon for Ukraine in its fight against Russia. The tiny drones have enabled Ukrainian soldiers to get the jump on Moscow's finest in more than a few conflicts, and have been valuable for capturing footage used for reconnaissance and even propaganda purposes. The only question we have left is simple. What does the future hold? Right now, the Black Hornet is relatively harmless in terms of its attack prowess. In short, it has none. There are no weapons built into the drone, meaning it exists solely to capture footage and shoot photos. But the potential exists to make it a much more dangerous device. Imagine a world where Teledyne FLIR decides to build a version of the Black Hornet that doesn't have a full array of cameras. Instead, they load it up with an explosive device, one that can be triggered from over a mile away, or thanks to the AI algorithms in the drone, programmed to explode once the Black Hornet reaches its location. The drone would become a silent killer. By the time the target realized that the drone was even there, it would be practically on top of them. It's only visible from 50 feet against a perfectly clear backdrop. You can only hear the minor buzzing the drone produces if the Black Hornet is 10 feet away. Could we see the war delve into scenarios where soldiers are constantly on the lookout for these miniature drones, taking pot shots at any they see to prevent them from causing serious damage? Perhaps militaries will start to counter these drones with new tech that surrounds their installations with simulated winds and rainwater, preventing the Black Hornets from penetrating. Only the future will tell. For now, the Black Hornet is one of the most powerful weapons Ukraine has at its disposal, even if it's not technically a weapon. It gives troops clear sets of eyes in the sky, eyes that can work day and night, that provide valuable information for missions. Added to the many other drones that Ukraine is using, as well as the many that its civilians use to capture footage for their own military, and Putin's war may go down in history as the first to truly feature drone warfare. So what do you think about the Black Hornet? Is this impressive little device everything that it's cracked up to be, or do you see flaws that could be overcome in the future? Maybe you have some other ideas about how it may be used to Ukraine's advantage. Tell us what you think in the comments, and thanks for watching the video.